I am getting so many requests for a class on epistaxis. So before going to epistaxis, that is bleeding from the nose, you should be thorough with the blood supply of septum as well as lateral wall of nose. So this is blood supply of septum and lateral wall. Both are almost the same, and we are getting supply from both internal carotid artery and also from the external carotid artery. But remember that there is no anastomosis. There is no anastomosis between internal carotid system and external carotid system. Okay, so from the internal, this is septum and this is lateral wall of nose. Anatomy of septum, here comes the cartilage, the perpendicular plate of ethmoid and vomer and the palatine bone. Okay, the lateral wall you are getting turbinates, the three turbinates and also the corresponding meatus. The blood supply of septum, it is from the internal carotid artery, comes the ophthalmic artery. And from the ophthalmic artery, there is anterior and posterior ethmoid artery. Okay, so think that in the roof, there is an ethmoid bone. So from the ophthalmic comes anterior ethmoid and also posterior ethmoid. Anterior ethmoid coming and supplying the anterior part, that is anterior ethmoid, and posteriorly there is posterior ethmoid. So ethmoid bone, anterior ethmoid and posterior ethmoid. Okay. And from the external carotid artery, there is facial artery and also maxillary. Remember that to the face, the facial artery is coming. And to the maxilla comes the maxillary artery. Both are branches of external carotid. Okay. And from the facial goes the superior labial. Think that in the to the nose, the around the nose comes the upper lip. So the superior labial. From facial, it has come to the septum through the upper lip. So superior labial artery. So the septal branches of superior labial artery comes here, coming and supplying the anterior part. Septal branches of superior labial artery. Okay. And from the maxillary artery, two branches are supplied. To the palatine area goes the greater palatine artery. And this is sphenoid area posteriorly. So to that area goes the sphenopalatine artery. Okay. So greater palatine and sphenopalatine. And sphenopalatine artery goes posteriorly and then it comes anteriorly. Okay. So sphenopalatine. Okay, so this is blood supply of septum. From the internal carotid artery, ophthalmic branches coming as anterior ethmoid and posterior ethmoid. And from the external carotid system, it is a facial through superior labial, septal branches of superior labial. And from the maxillary, it is greater palatine and sphenopalatine. And these four branches are coming and anastomosing in the Little's area, which is in the andro-inferior part of septum. Okay, Little's area. So this Little's area again can be asked for undergraduates. This can be asked as in the drawing label part. That is important. And this Little's area is the most common site of an anterior epistaxis. Okay. And in the Little's area, there is no supply of posterior ethmoid. Only the four named branches are coming in the Little's area. Posterior ethmoid is not coming there. So it is from the internal carotid and external carotid system, but without any anastomosis between this internal carotid and external carotid system. So, and what about the lateral wall? In the lateral wall also, this is the same type of blood supply. from internal carotid system and from the external carotid system. So similar to this, internal carotid artery, same supply through ophthalmic branches, it comes the anterior ethmoid and posterior ethmoid. Okay, and it is the lateral internal nasal branch. Lateral nasal, it is supply, as it is supplying the lateral wall, it is a lateral internal nasal. Okay, so lateral internal nasal branches of anterior ethmoid and posterior ethmoid. Okay, so lateral internal nasal branch of posterior ethmoid. If there is an internal nasal, there will be an external nasal also. So this anterior ethmoid has got an external nasal branch also, that is external nasal branch of anterior ethmoid artery. Okay, and similar to the septum, from the external carotid artery, facial artery, then the greater palatine and sphenopalatine. Okay, and the sphenopalatine is coming in the lateral wall through the sphenopalatine foramen. So from the sphenopalatine foramen comes the sphenopalatine artery and also descending palatine artery. And this descending palatine artery is not supplying much to the septum. Septum, it is mainly through the greater palatine, and the only difference is in the lateral wall, descending palatine artery is also giving a major supply. So sphenopalatine and greater descending palatine, both descending palatine is also a terminal branch of maxillary artery. Okay, and greater palatine also, and the facial, it is not the superior labial, but it is the angular branch, angular artery. More of supply to the lateral wall is through the angular artery. So again, it is the internal carotid artery and external carotid artery. Internal carotid artery through the anterior ethmoid and posterior ethmoid itself, lateral internal nasal and external nasal. And from the facial, it is the angular artery, then greater palatine and sphenopalatine and descending palatine. So this is arterial supply. And in the venous drainage, in the septum, from the lateral anterior part, it is going into the facial venous fluxes, facial vein, venous, from anterior part it is going to the facial system, facial vein, and in the posterior part it is going to the pterygoid vein, it is the pterygoid fluxes. Okay, so anteriorly to the facial vein and posteriorly from the septal part it is the into the pterygoid fluxes. But in the lateral wall, similar to this, anterior part again going to the facial vein, from the posterior part it is going to the pharyngeal plexus, and in the middle part it is going to the pterygoid plexus. Okay, that is the another difference between the venous drainage in the septum and lateral wall. In the septum there is only two systems, into the anteriorly to the facial vein and posteriorly into the pterygoid plexus. But in the lateral wall, anteriorly it is to the, again into the facial, and the middle part it is into the pterygoid, and posteriorly, think posteriorly comes the pharynx, so into the pharyngeal plexus. Okay, so this is the arterial and the venous drainage of septum and the lateral wall. With this knowledge, it will be easy for you to learn more on epistaxis.